book. I was standing in the corner store just waiting in line. Woke up laying on a gurney, disoriented and shook. A young gangster walked in the door holding a 9. 5 shadows stood over me, one read me the rules. He left one worker in the closet bound and gagged. The other 4 dispersed and started grabbing surgical tools. He told a cashier to clear the rack and fill up the bag. I felt heavily sedated, but still I was scared. He was driving a black hoop parked out in front of the place. Wanted to talk, but my ability to speak was impaired. He did a double take and came back when he looked at my face. A laser lacerated my skull, but I felt no pain. He ran out and smashed the gas like he was trying to break it. A tube drained and extracted the chemicals from my brain. I untied the dude and bailed out, just happy to make it. Out of body experience, my conscience withdrew. The cops showed up, my mind still replaying the images. I'm watching them operate on me from an overhead view. They questioned me before I was able to exit the premises. Seconds later, I was home still feeling the anesthesia. Of course your boy didn't say nothing, though they questioned me well. I don't know what they did, but I was weakened by the procedure. Besides that, they had masks on, so it was nothing to tell. Somebody's beating on my front door, it's my girl in a rage. When I went back to the hood, I ain't mentioned the heist. Crying, asking me where I've been, cause she ain't seen me in days. But boys had already found out the previous night. I gave her a roll of tissue and said, "What's your issue?" I got a call on my house phone, a block number at noon. "What the hell you mean, days? I just hung up with you." They said, "I know you talk to the laws, man. I'll get with you soon." As we debated, I felt weaker, so she sat beside me. Before I could explain, they hung the phone up quick. She said, "We talked last Tuesday, Kate. Today is Friday. Now I'm a target in my own hood for no reason. I'm sick." I said, "Yeah, Tuesday the 25th is the date." "Well, if it's war, then I guess it's gonna be war. That's the biz." But when I checked my calendar, it said Friday the 28th. The worst part was not knowing who the enemy is. I sent her home, still trying to account for the lost time. I withdrew from everybody, even family and friends. The experience I had instantly crossed my mind. I'm trusting no man or woman, the paranoia kicks in. Later that night, I went to sleep, and 1 or 2 hours in, I'm tripping hard, staying up all night, stressed out. I found myself in the process of being abducted again. Jumping every time I hear a strange sound in the house. They repeated the same process and entered my head. Should I move, change my number? I don't know what to do. But this time somehow I heard every word that they said. My mama let me know that they've been called in her house too. One of them said this is the last session and typed in a code. Could this be real or is somebody joking or bluffing? It inserted a blue microscopic cranial probe. If I could just let them know I ain't told the police nothing. As I struggled to talk, the monitor started blinking. 1 week after the robbery, I'm just chilling at home. And on the screen was printed out every word I was thinking. Scared to put my people in this, so I'm mobbing alone. I thought, why, as my body lay in stabilization. Somebody knocked at my front door, so I looked through the blinds. One of them said, "We need your brainwaves to produce our nation. Whatever gon' happen, I'm ready for it. Now's the time." Our civilization's in danger, that's why we have you here. I snatched the door open, but didn't recognize this man. "We've been abducting you on and off for about the last 2 years. He was with 2 dudes, one of them had some gloves on his hand. We duplicated your whole mind, the entire infinite tree." I said, "Let me tell you what happened, and please refrain. Our people breathe from intellect, not physical intimacy. If y'all gon' take me out, at least give me a chance to explain." I said, "Man, if I can save a whole planet, then let it be." They said, "Ain't nothing to explain, homie. We already know. Especially if their mental propensity is like me." "It's all good. I'm the young G that robbed the store." They emerged from the shadows, a princess and a prince. And even though you couldn't see my face, you still didn't rat. They sent me back home that second and I ain't heard from them since. We used the cash to flip a bigger lick. Here's 10 G's, black. Now if you heard everything I said and you still confused about the direction I was going and the style that I used, take a second to rewind, concentrate and you'll find that I just told you 2 stories at the same time. Now if you heard everything I said and you still confused about the direction I was going and the style that I used, take a second to rewind, concentrate and you'll find that I just told you 2 stories at the same time. Yeah.